Hey guys, welcome to Driving with John in GTA. I'm currently getting beat up and run over. Gotta dodge my fucking punch. This guy's a better fighter than I am. I need to learn how to do that, dodge punches and stuff in the game. I think it's just like hit X or something. Yeah, I always forget that I have the dodo that we can land on water, so we're gonna land on some water. Oh, that's crap. I know I can drive over this. Maybe not in this car. Ooh. That was painful. Since I've called in a plane, I think they will be gracious and open the gates for me. I really need those guys to leave me alone. Well, I'm not talking much today, am I, guys? I don't know. What's going on? Well, we're gonna fly this dodo. I don't know if any of you have ever seen this. Do you see the lines on the fender here? I've noticed that sometimes when on certain cars, when it goes into a damaged model, there's lines on the fender. I don't know, it's... See, the other fender's like that too. I don't know what's up with that. This is huge. I have a 46-inch TV in my living room, and my parents got rid of their projection 55-inch TV, and they were just gonna, I guess they were just gonna take it to the dump or something, and it works perfectly fine. I don't know. I was just like, I'll take it if you guys don't want it. So now I've got a 55-inch projection TV, which doesn't have the greatest picture, but it is bigger, and it's also right in front of me. So it's like I'm playing GTA in a freaking theater right now. This is great. Slow this thing down. And there we go. We have done what this plane's specialty is. Which is pretty cool that they put this in here. I don't know if you guys have ever played with this plane. But you can actually land. You can land pretty hard. And still be okay. It's fairly tough, and thankfully flies much better than dodos of past. I wonder if I can do a barrel roll. What what are those words? About 150 feet, 200 feet. Yeah, we did it. What are we down to? 100 feet. I lost a little bit of altitude. pretty maneuverable plane. Oh, you know I'm gonna try it. Oh, caught the wing. I caught the wing. Uh-oh. Oh, that was pretty good. That was nice and smooth. Let's check out the wing. I don't see any parts flopping around. So yeah, I caught the wing on a bridge, and this thing is still just fine. So it's a tough bird. Pretty cool, too. Can't really gain altitude on its side. Yeah, it can. It's doing alright. Doesn't want to go down. Well, not the most maneuverable of planes, but not horrible by any means. It's pretty good. And you don't really fear doing stuff like this because, you know, if you land in the water, oh well. Well, this is just fun. Almost caught the wing in the water. I'm sure, absolutely sure, that's not healthy for the plane. Oh, jeez. Do we have a long enough stretch to land this thing? Or would I just tear the wings off? Oh yeah, we're taking it down here. Oh, I caught the wing. And it's fine. See that? Are we even scuffed on the wing at all? Yeah, it's scuffed a bit. Or that's a light out there on the edge. No, it's scuffed. So I have caught that wing on two things now. I have just scuffed it. I'm gonna say that's pretty good. Is the water carrying me? Maybe? Uh-oh. So it doesn't want to turn well on the water. There we go. You gotta have more speed than I have. Oh crap. We ain't gonna make it, guys. The landing gear won't come out for me right now. But hey, if we get back in the water, we might be okay. This is absolutely ridiculous and shouldn't happen. Alright, let's get floating again. Come on. Just a little bit further. Okay. You know, since the water's going that way, that will give me a little bit of airspeed. She's smoking now. I've been rough on her, though. Whoa, crap. Too much speed. Stuck on the rocks. Well, that's not good. We're gonna get this bird turned around, though. There we go. Oh, that was the wrong way. Alright, now we're gonna use the water's momentum to help me take off, and I don't have as much of a climb to do here. I'm pulling back. Yeah. Oh. I didn't make it. I felt like that was mildly entertaining, though. The cleanup crews out here are great. My airplane's already gone. And now my butt's wet. I died here. chances. Yeah, I'm not getting a car. Let's call one in. What to drive?
You calling for some wheels? I'm Johnny on the spot. I'll hook you up.
Oh, my Duke's screwed up. That sucks. Duke's. See, it shows the Mesa is scrapped. I don't know why that is. Apparently, I can't get that back. I might have to buy another one, and that just sucks. Ah, I don't. Oh yeah, I remember. One of the videos I said I was going to drive this car more, so okay, we're going to drive this car. Hey, I got a little bit of Pepsi left. Cool. Oh, there it is. Looking away from the screen for a second. I like these ultralight style wheels, but I might have to put the endos on it. Might have to paint it too. The flat blue is cool. But I feel like black might look better. Anticlimactic on the actual takeoff after all that tire spinning. Oh, hey guys. Having a little off-road race? Well, excuse me. Yeah, we might need to take this car into the shop and see what kind of mods it can have. Spin move. Aw. Rather like this car. Wish the rear windows weren't quite as long as they are. I feel that kind of takes away from the look of the car. The windows should be a little bit smaller to be of this time period they're representing this car as. I'll say having a larger TV and having it much closer. Yeah, I can see traffic a lot better. When I originally got my flat screen, the 46-inch, I sized it for how my living room was set up at the time. My living room's actually pretty large. But, I looked at all the little charts and for my seating distance and all that
What's
stuff.
What's wrong with her now?
The 46 was perfect, you know, the proper size. So that's what we went with. The whole time my wife is saying, need a bigger TV. It's too small. Need a bigger TV. Bumperless, yeah. Of course, I didn't listen. Because I'm stubborn. I like that, because that goes under the axle and looks like IRS. Side exit exhaust, is that a little bit too 60s for me right now? Yeah, I like the two pipes coming out the back. That looks good. Hood. Yeah, secondary color. Anyway, so got the TV for the living room size, and then, you know, changed how the living room is set up. So now the TV's way too far away, way small. Yeah. Black. Because black cars look good. And yeah, we haven't really done anything in this video. It's already been on 15 minutes. I'm having fun. I do sport, chrome, I don't even have enough money for chrome rims. Those are too big for this car. That's a bit much. Those look good, Magnum 500 styles. I've got enough money. Oh, I don't have enough money. I want those. Those are vet. Those just go on a vet. I mean, yeah. $73,000 for wheels. It's crazy, but we're gonna do it. So let's use this car and make some money to buy some wheels for it. I'm digging it in black. It looks good. Going to cinematic mode. crap. Let's think about your place, guy. Okay. That was dumb. I was looking further down the road. Concentrate. What kind of races we got happening over here? 4th of July ramp. We'll try it. We'll give it a shot. Oh wow, that looks fun. Muscle. Yes, I would like to launch this job on my own. How many gas tankers can you jump? I mean, if I'm jumping stuff, I mean, you know. But no, we're going to use the... Oh crap, it's under Sports Classics, isn't it? Well then, darn, I just have to use this. I thought it was under Muscle, but no. I feel okay with this though. This feels right. Orange Charger jumping over things. Are there no boosts, or did I not have it on GTA Race? I need to see what I'm doing. Well, I guess I cleared them. I guess I didn't clear them. Huh. All that excessive use of the checkpoints in this race. Ah, that's funny. Well, that was a little bit anticlimactic. Let's do that again with more laps. Can I? No, I can't. So, replay. There's a race up there called Crossing Path that it shows I haven't done. Pretty sure I have done that one. Standard. I mean, you just gotta do it in the Charger, so. Client invites. Well, that's cool. So, friends can invite people to it. That's. Crap, did I leave it on one lap? I don't want to quit. I get to talking and then just fail at everything else. See, I always call this like a Charger because it looks like a Charger from the side, but that's almost got a Pontiac badge on the front. Oh yeah. Whoever made this race has a similar sense of humor to myself. Oh, that was cool. That was a nice little finish there. Oops. I'm breathing into the mic. Okay. Now, I need you guys to yell at me. Because I'm going to hit replay again. And I just want to do two laps. So I just yell when I need to set it to two. You know, I don't want boosts. I think that just clutters it up. Two. Three. Oh, we know the Charger can do it. Let's try the Vet. Uh-oh. There we go. What? All my stats were like crap. That's not right. If this car doesn't clear it, I just don't know what to say. Oh yeah, I think we got it. That would be better than the Pontiac GTO Charger. Orange car. I wonder if he did that on purpose or if he thought he had to use them all. Now, you know, I don't know if we're at top speed when we hit that ramp. We'd be able to tell. Let's see how fast we're going when we hit it. About 110. You guys are gonna have to excuse me. We gotta get this old car up to about 150-ish, which I think is about the top speed. I've been a little bit too fast there. It's okay though. Oh, keep moving some to the side. I don't want to move it to the side. A little bit faster. About 120. We definitely got more air. You guys are going to have to excuse me. I do want to try this in a faster car. Ow. We'll just do one lap though, and I'll just go back from the start and go as fast as I can. We're gonna do the Coquette this time. I think there's one car that jumps better than the Coquette, and I can't remember what it is. You know, the Adder jumps well. You might as well use that, right? My wife, lovely lady that she is going to be less than thrilled when she gets up in the morning and comes in here and there's a extension cord run across the living room and a TV right dead square in the middle of the living room. Okay, that was about the same as that vet, so now we go back and get some sped. And dodge. Dodge all of the car-killing rocks. I can't freaking see the speedometer. I really can't see it. That's 100. I'm gonna have to sit up here. Those little letters are so... digits, I guess. They're so small. Okay, I'm gonna get out of the car here so I can do this. Turn. Yeah, that car spun on me. There's 80. There's 100. Yeah, it hit it about 110. But we definitely got more air on that one. Okay, one more time. One more time and I'll be done. We'll do this one from outside in the car. Yes, I know I'm going the wrong way. I'm having fun. Leave me alone. Oops. Kind of weird how the trailers or the tanks show up before the ramps. Wow. I'd say that's probably the best one yet. Really, I missed that. I thought I'd be close enough to get it. That. In all this lovely rain we had recently, this rainiest May ever, I had an interesting problem. My dryer vent clogged up, and my washer and dryer right in the middle of my house. Absolutely horrible place for them. Dipping in. I think this is a decent race. We'll do one lap. Sports classics. Anyway, yeah, my dryer wasn't working very well. And the dryer vent goes under the slab and then out beside my house. And you could walk outside and you could hear it going blah, 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 blah. It's not like air bubbles blowing through water, and that's exactly what it was. We had so much rain that it was full. Now, I feel like an idiot. I had my, I got my dad to come over and help me. He has drain snakes and such, so he come over and we were looking at it, and I walk out there and he's got the cap on the outside to the dryer vent off. I was like, how did you get that off? He was like, oh, I just wiggled it and pulled it off. I'm like, come again. I was like, I was out here just completely struggling with that thing. And then I looked at it and I was like, oh, I thought just the top of it came off and part of the PVC that actually went down to the tube under the house. I thought that PVC was, you know, glued in place and didn't move. So I was holding the PVC at the bottom and pulling on the piece at the top. Basically, I was working against myself since the whole thing came off. So my left hand was holding the bottom piece of it, holding it down, and my right hand was pulling up. I just wasn't going anywhere. Yeah, I felt like a moron. It was just a simple thing. And, you know, once we got the tube off, then you could see the water right there, so stuck a shop back in there and fixed it, but... One of many moments, I'm like, you know what? I'm smarter than that. I could have figured that crap out. Not that I didn't appreciate the help, it was just like... I was working against myself. I feel like that more often than not lately, though. This whole, doing a night job for years on end, which I don't like working nights, I never have. But never getting, like, for years now, I've slept during the day, and I don't sleep well during the day, and I'm like most people. You know, there's guys I work with, they have to take a bunch of sleeping pills and all kinds of stuff just so they can stay sane. And I'm not quite that bad, but... It definitely hurts me. I can't think as clear as I used to. I know that for sure. And the older I get, the more difficult it is on me. I used to be able to sleep, you know, with just the blinds closed. And now it has to be like, for a while, you know, I take like a blanket and then put it up kind of over the blinds, drape it over and block a little bit more light. And now it has to be pitch black or I don't sleep. You know, if you're a night owl and you like working nights, ain't good for you. That's cool. That's whatever. It doesn't, you know, if it works for you, it works for you. But just not for me. I work with some guys. They absolutely love working nights. They've always liked it. And I spun out right before the finish line. It's... I'm yawning. It's nighttime right now. It's 15 till midnight. And tonight I'm making GTA videos. Last night I made... My voice keeps going out. Allergies suck, by the way. Anyway. Last night I made Minecraft videos. Like, I don't know when this video here I'm making is going to come out. Helicopter race. That sucks. We're gonna do it, though. This will probably come out mid-late June, I think. My Minecraft stuff's already into July. And just for reference, it's a 15 till midnight on June 1st when I'm making this. One of these days I'll find myself one of these days, hopefully very, very soon, I'll find myself a good job on days. I have the opportunity to go to days right now in my current business where I work right now. But it's not that enticing, the 12-hour shifts I do right now. You know, if you ask most people, you know, how much they do in a day in terms of, you know, people working office, in terms of calls, emails, and blah blah blah, whatever. And, you know, I'm pretty even with a lot of people and how their workload, but moving to days in the spots that are open right now would have me working about 14 hours a day. For you know, it varies. You're supposed to do like 3.5 days a week, 12 hours. But what I see from our guys on first shift right now, it ends up being about 5 days a week, and sometimes 6 days a week at 14 hours minimum. Because, I mean, I do a 12-hour shift there. They get there before I go home, and they're there 2 hours usually after I get back to work at night. So, geez. And that would be fine. I'm not against working, and I'm not against, you know, quite a bit more workload and more stress that like that job would have. What I am against, though, is the fact that it wouldn't pay anymore. So, you know, even though it's a salary position, if you split it down by hour, I'd be making about as much as a kid that works at McDonald's or something. Maybe that's a bad one to use, because McDonald's people are trying to get that $15 an hour. We're not going to get into that too much. But yeah, I mean, if you break it down per hour, and you're working 70, 80 hours a week for what I'm currently making, I'm not going to say, but it's not bad, but it's not great. You know, it becomes, you know, by the hour, it becomes not much at all. And that just doesn't seem enticing to me. You know, I tell people I want a Monday through Friday 8-to-5 gig, and it seems like some people think that's like lazy. It's like, I don't necessarily think I'll work 8-to-5. I just want the schedule to be 8-to-5. If I gotta show up at 7 and stay till 6 every day, I'll do it. If the pay's right, I'll work longer than that. I'll show up at 6 and leave at 7. But the key thing is there, I want it to be under my terms. If I need to stay longer to get the work done and it's work I want to do, then I'm all for it. But if it's like forced on you, you know, the shift is, quotes in the air, 12 hours, and you're not going to get the work done in that amount of time because it's more than you can do in 12 hours, not so much. It just has no appeal to me. And maybe I'm lazy. Because let's do a motorcycle race. other people do it, but man, I don't know. None of them seem to enjoy it. Well, this is a depressing conversation, isn't it? Go back. No. Crap. I had a custom bike I could have used, I think. Maybe that was my custom bike. No, my custom one's blue. Anyway, now it's not that I don't like working where I work. I guess it's just more the department. There's a pricing analyst spot that I put in for I would really, really like to get. But that's what I want to do. I don't know if I've said it in these GTA videos. I think I've said it in my Minecraft videos, but I've gone to school for quite a few years now and got myself an MBA and would like to steer my career towards analyst type roles, which I feel I'd be... Oh, that goes off road there. Oh, wow, that killed me. I feel I'd be good in an analyst role. Very numbers oriented person. I don't know as much about Excel as I need to know. However, every time I need to use Excel or show someone something, I always find out that I know more than they do. But I do know enough about the program to know that I don't know anything about the program. I think that means I do know something, I guess. However that works out. Oh, that's a decent little lab. That's kind of fun. Not really worthy of a dirt bike. I mean, where's the jumps? So let's just wheelie! And... Oh, hey! There we go. Alright. I have no clue what I hit. I know which way to go now, so that's gonna help me. I guess there's a little jumps there, but... nothing special. I go back and listen to my videos, and I'm always clearing my throat through the whole thing. I apologize for that. But, like I said, allergies suck. First. Yep. 2940. Like, now I'm sitting here like, oh, I'm almost to 134. I could keep doing a few races and get up to 134. But that's not why we're here. If you guys remember, we are here to get chrome rims on my car. So that's what we're going to do. $60,000 for wheels. Are you kidding me? I feel like I shouldn't do it. Like, why are they $60,000? Like, I get that it's kind of an RPG and that you have to level up and earn money, blah, 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 all that stuff, but $60,000 for a set of wheels is so unrealistic that it just feels like they're trying to get people to buy the cash card things. How do I feel about the cash cards? I've bought a few here and there. But... But... It is a bit of a cheat. I mean... Well, I say that, but then, I mean, I don't know. I've used them for things. You know, me and one of my buddies would play, and we'd have more fun if we had the tank, so I didn't have enough money for the tank, and put in a little bit and bought the tank. So I guess it's whatever. I could definitely see someone doing like what I'm doing the YouTube thing, using the cash cards, because you want to make a video and not grind for money. Unless you're making a video where you grind for money, and in that case, it's whatever. I want... What do the chrome endos look like? Probably crap. Where are they? There we go. It just doesn't have that old school cool, does it? I was gonna do those because that's a kind of a classic Corvette looking wheel. I don't think I'm going to do that though. We're gonna do something different. I don't know what yet. Yeah, those actually look pretty cool. I like how some of these have four lug nuts on them. That's pretty funny. What's the difference in those two? Just the, huh. Oh, that's awful. I mean, that's what I had on here, though. Because they do look like the old ultralight wheels. Think we're
Now
gonna go with
that's a
those.
custom job.
They don't look very chrome. And I'll be honest, for $50-something thousand, I want them to look very chrome. They do have some shine though when you're going down the road. They look pretty good. Yeah, I dig it. Hey, missed that guy on the motorcycle. But not much. So what do you to celebrate that you have brand new chrome wheels? You rob a convenience store. But first, you hood slide
Another
into
day,
the
another
convenience
dollar.
store.
You'll get your money.
Out. Pull a gun, I'm gonna shoot you. Oh, that handle never worked again. Oh. Car has more grip off-road than I thought it would. Or on dirt roads. And then it goes and breaks loose, and it's just not driving how I think it's going to. Okay. Now the cops have caught up to me, we can have a little bit of chase. Oh crap. Shotgun right through the window. They stole my car. We gotta get my car back. I mean, they didn't really steal it, they kinda impounded it after I killed one of them. So I get it. But yeah, we gotta get my car back. I see things from other people's point of view to the point where I can rarely be mad at anyone. It's like I don't like what you did, but I understand why you did it. But then some people are just jerks, and I don't understand why they do things. And I do get mad at those people. Am I talking about any specific event? Absolutely not. I'm just randomly speaking. Yeah. So I took my son up to babysitters today My wife normally takes him on her way to work, but I let her sleep in a little bit and took him up there before I went to bed. And I noticed something rather frustrating while I was driving. Excuse me for putting massive pause between my words. I thought I was about to sneeze. I noticed something really, really frustrating. I almost got hit by four cars in 14 miles, and I could clearly see that every person that almost hit me was on their cell phone, or staring at their phone, texting, reading something, I don't know, something. Now, I could see that very clearly because they were, one, very close, and two, I wasn't on my cell phone. None of them ever looked up or ever saw me. I had to dodge four cars, two of them completely, or one completely in my lane, and, how did that work out? I don't really know how. They must have swerved too, because I didn't go in the ditch, and that was my only option at the time, so I scooted way over, and there was a wide shoulder. I was almost completely off the road. Ugh. Now that I think about that a little bit more, it was a lot closer than I originally thought. The second one was halfway in my lane, and I swerved around them easily. One ran a stop sign, and the other one didn't run a stop sign, but I pulled up and stopped, and then they stopped about a second and a half later. I mean, enough distance to tell that, yeah, they're still rolling, and I've already come to a complete stop. And so I'm halfway through the intersection, and they just take off and just almost T-bone me. And I look over, just staring at the cell phone, never even... And they didn't slow down. They just... I don't know. Put your freaking cell phones down, people. That's what I got to say about that. That's the other stuff that frustrates me, too. Like, you go to a park or something, and kids going, "Mommy, Mommy, look at what I'm doing. Mom, hey, Mom, 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 Mom." And Mom's sitting there on her freaking cell phone. Put it down. Jeez. I mean, by the time my kid can go to a park and run and play and do all kinds of stuff, I'm going to be 34, 35, but I will wear myself out. I will push myself to a point where my muscles are so ridiculously sore that I can barely move to keep up with him and play with him. I actually can't wait to run and chase and play and do all kinds of stuff, because you're only going to have that for a few years. And then he's going to be he's going to be a tween, and then a teen, and then, gone. So there will be absolutely no looking back saying, "I wish I did this," or "I wish I did that." No. We're going to play. We're going to play a lot. And if he wants to go camp in the backyard, we're going to camp in the backyard. We're going to have some fun. Absolutely cannot wait. Yeah, I plan on getting a better job. I hope I don't get something that takes me away a lot. Was it just me, or was that Prius going like 100+ miles an hour? I feel like that was the game screwing with me. Aw. Oh, you flipped me off? Stick that arm back out the window. I better get moving. I forgot this car has giant freaking side windows. Come here, motorcycle. Ooh. About that truck. Pow. I got him. And around the truck, too. That worked out well. Deep. Hey, there's somebody jogging down here. Never seen that before. This car doesn't move very fast in the air. It doesn't change directions quickly in the air. It would be a really, really nice, awesome car if it did that for me. But nay. Hey. There's a couple dinghies out here. Quit playing with your dinghy. Tommy Boy is a great movie. And so is Black Sheep, for that matter. Never really hear about Black Sheep much anymore. I love that movie. What was his last name in that movie? Something like Donnelly or something like that. His brother was trying to become a senator or mayor or something. He was running for some kind of office. And had to put Chris Farley, basically get him out of town because he just kept screwing everything up. Made the campaign look bad. And then, you know, there's the scene with the hot rod police car with nitrous. The bottle breaks loose and him and David Spade are high in the car, and I can't remember the line exactly, but something about a guy being like wanted upstate for banging horses or something. It's just absolutely hilarious. I get that in my Ben Stein-esque voice nothing sounds funny. Hey cop car, get out of my way. Trying to ramp here. Train! Yes! Right over the train. And into a helicopter. Because ramping, not just ramping is fun, but if you can ramp over a vehicle, it's funner. It's another freaking blue Prius. Not really a fan of those cars, or most hybrids, but yeah, because diesels are better. Yep. Diesels are the way to go. Europe has it figured out. I don't know why the US doesn't. A bunch of reasons for not liking hybrids. A lot of it is all that they claim to save in terms of pollution. You still can't get the pollution making the batteries and making the car in the first place. You get more making those type of cars than you do others because of the extra processing that's involved, and not just in transporting materials, but in actual manufacturing work of making all the batteries, because it's an extra component that most cars don't have. Ooh, that hurt me. And it landed outside the fence. Oh crap, that cop car. That guy should get a medal. Yeah, we're in a tight spot. They got me. But some people like hybrids, like the idea of it. I think the South Park episode where the people who got hybrids were ridiculously smug, and the smug cloud was coming over the land. That was one of their best. I'll take that. Lady landed with her face on the concrete. Got a nice sunroof on this one. Cool. But yeah, I mean, I don't, you know, and most of the hybrids that they have don't get as good a gas mileage as they are supposed to get, and blah blah blah, a bunch of crap with that. Just get a freaking diesel. You have 40 to 50 miles per gallon always. Less maintenance. You don't have to worry about replacing the batteries at some point, which, I mean, it used to be a big deal with the hybrids, replacing the batteries. They were crazy expensive. It's not like that so much anymore. They're still expensive, but not as bad. Oh, excuse me. I don't know. The whole thing just seems off to me. Like, if you really want a more efficient car that gets better fuel mileage and gets, you know, save the environment and everything, just make it freaking lighter. I know that we have these crazy crash safety standards in this country, but, you know, offer some, you know, that's why we have waivers. That's why we have lawyers. Offer somebody the ability to buy a 2,000-pound car that, yeah, if they get hit, they might get crushed, but, you know, they signed a waiver saying they wouldn't sue you. So, hey, good to go. Is that how it really works? Yeah, it could. It's not, but, yeah. I don't know. I just don't, just grinded that on the rail. I don't know. I would much prefer the U.S. have small, lightweight cars with diesel engines. That's just me, though. I would also prefer everything being manual transmission. Actually, I mean, even better than diesel cars, people in the U.S. need to embrace motorcycles. Yeah, I'm from the U.S. and I'm a overweight guy who plays video games. I'm possibly extremely stereotypical of people in the U.S. But I will say that we need to embrace motorcycles. You can get rain gear. You can fix your hair back when you get to work. You can shoot this cop. But yeah, seriously, you know, I've seen some stats and I don't remember the exact numbers now, so it's really not good to talk stats unless you know numbers, but you know, something like if you know, 50% of the people in the country rode motorcycles to work, something like 75 or 80% of the time, which that does include some rainy days, it would basically just end traffic jams. Of course, you also have to get, states to legalize, well, I can't freaking talk. You have to get states to legalize lane splitting, and not stupid guys doing 100 miles an hour between cars going 70 miles an hour lane splitting. You know, if traffic stopped, you can roll between them at 10, 15 mile an hour lane splitting just to keep moving. It's legal in California, where everything is illegal. That one thing is actually pretty nice. You would have to educate the public on it too, because the average Joe hates people being ahead of them. What is up with people and their freaking egos? I don't get it. Like, you know, you pass somebody, they get all upset and think it's some kind of battle, and they're going to pass you and they're going to get you, and they swerve all through traffic and flip you off and all kinds of stuff. And it's like, I'm just cruising along and I get people like swerve at me and flipping me off, and like, hey, I can't help it that you've been swerving through traffic for 20 minutes and you've only made two car spaces. I'm just listening to a song on, like, calm down. Motorcycles, people. That's the answer. Better than when she came in, yeah. And if you want to argue that motorcycle insurance is too high, it wouldn't be if most everybody was on motorcycles and our motorcycle education was better in terms of driver education. I mean, it still might be higher than someone in a car because you have more risk. However, if most people were on motorcycles, a motorcycle accident is better than a motorcycle and car accident. And they don't have to be 150 mile an hour plus bikes. I mean, you know, people still might want to go 70, 80 on the interstate, so a 500cc bike is, you know, more than enough. Maybe its top speed is 90. And I'm not talking about a cross rocket type bike either. I'm talking about a smaller bike. You know, there are 600cc four cylinders that are very fast, but that are also smaller bikes that, you know, they're not that fast. Their top speed, maybe 90. That's fine. You don't have to be cool. You don't have to be Billy Badass riding your motorcycle. It's about transportation and low costs, and that's what we need here in this country, low-cost transportation. And we need to appease the, or I guess we have to appease the tree hugger groups. The motorcycles get good gas mileage, so there you go on that. There's less parts to them, so they're less environmentally hazardous to make in the first place in the factories. Motorcycles, guys. I don't know why we don't embrace them more. What is this little curbiness? I've never driven on this or seen it. Always come by here way too fast, apparently. Oh, man, I'm being stupid. We need to drift this thing. My other gripe with electric cars and hybrids and stuff is like, that, you know, other people have said this, it's not just my concern, but that power has to come from somewhere. So you're not turning fossil fuels into hydrocarbons and such in your car, driving every day in your full electric vehicle. Oh no! Oh, back it up. I want to save this, but I don't think it's... Nope, not going to be possible. Yeah, so let's just end it. I'll have to get another one. Anyway, so you're not... You got a full electric vehicle, you plug it in, and you're all pretentious and such, and you think that, hey, cool, whatever. Where's the electricity come from? You know, at best it came from a nuclear or hydroelectric power plant. It probably came from a coal-burning power plant. Most likely. So you're still burning fossil fuels and putting all the stuff in the air that you don't really want in the air and think you're not putting in the air by driving that little electric car. They have really good torque, though. I don't really have anything against electric cars. It's just the, what I do have a problem with is the pretentiousness of people that tend to drive them and the fact that some of that stuff is being forced on people when there are better alternative solutions. I got a nice sweater. I love driving down the sidewalks in this game. It's horrible, but I enjoy it. This one's a fake one. You're like, oh, cool, we're going to make good progress. No, we're not. And how about the person that lives in this house? I've seen so many videos online of people go down this one thinking it's the next one down and run into the buildings there. What is this guy got walking like he got something stuck up his butt? This is apparently helping my strength. So what do we got going on? We got cops. I guess we'll end this video there, guys. You've heard enough about what I think about, electric cars and stuff for today. Yeah, I guess we'll... I don't want to stop playing. Meh. Got some good air on that lady. Alright, we're done for the week, guys. Hope you enjoy it. Like and subscribe. We will see you next week. Or 2 days from now. GTA videos every 3 days. Yeah, 2 days. 3 a week. What am I talking about? Who knows?